can happen when we allow ourselves to stand out from the crowd. Let the enemy beware. It's April 1918, and this great war has now been going on for 4 long years. Your name is Manfred von Richthofen. You are known by your fellow flyers as a legendary leader. You are known by your enemy as a legend. You are the Red Baron, and you are leading your flying circus into battle today. Your companions are an elite group of pilots under your command. They follow you, each in brightly colored planes, reflecting the personality and power of the individual behind the controls. You reflect on the men that make up your squadron.
Like many of these flyers, we rose from the nobility of Germany. Early in the war, we fought in the cavalry, as the eyes of the army. We were trained to be highly mobile, to seek out the enemy and report our findings to the slower-moving army. That is, until the war bogged down into trench warfare. The eyes of the army then moved to the skies. And many of us followed. As new tactics developed in the air, it became imperative to deprive the enemy of their eyes of the army. And so, the fighter pilot was born. In many ways, we are knights of the air, continuing the age-old tradition of chivalry. The noble steeds we mount now have wings, each one bearing our personal colors, as did the knights before us. Just as we did as horse-bound cavalry, we ride swiftly to support the needs of our army. Our planes are disassembled, loaded on trains, and are deployed where they can do the greatest good. When the train arrives behind the lines, our brightly colored planes cause quite a thrill, much like the arrival of the circus coming to town. We are known as the Flying Circus.
You were fortunate in having a hand in the selection of your new steed. The German High Command saw fit to gather aircraft manufacturers together. They submitted their latest designs for evaluation in a fly-off process by notable pilots, and there is no more notable a pilot than you.
What do you think, Herr Rittmeister?
An interesting concept, this triplane. It's compact, a bit tricky to fly, and it wants to ground loop on landing. The wooden skids on the bottom wing are testimony to that. It's a bit unstable, but very maneuverable. It turns very quickly, great for getting behind our foe in a dogfight. The middle wing at eye level makes for poor visibility in the air. Forward visibility on the ground is almost non-existent with the tail down, although the cutout in the wing helps a little.
The wings are thicker than most because of the box spar construction. This gives them strength without having to use wire bracing like a biplane. The extra lift from the third wing and small wing on the landing gear allows it to outclimb any enemy fighter.
Yeah, but the extra drag makes it slower. You do not have the luxury of outrunning or outdiving the enemy.
But Baron, your reputation as a great leader is complemented by your reputation as a great marksman. The guns are standard, synchronized to fire through the propeller.
A wise fighter pilot tries to pick his battles. Diving in from the sun or from behind and below where the enemy can't see you. You need to use the talents and skills of plane and pilot to gain the advantage from the outset. This plane has attributes that suit my character. It's a great gun mount, it performs, and is instantly recognizable from a distance. There is only one thing missing.
Jawohl, Herr Rittmeister.
Paint it red. All red. Let the enemy know who they are meeting.
The sun glistens off your three wings as you bank and dip effortlessly through the blue sky. Other colorful steeds fly next to you, fellow knights on a quest for enemy aircraft. However glorious this feels, the destination is a challenging one, a bloody one. You have a mission for your country and a reputation to uphold. It has not been easy. You peer down the wings of your unique plane. It has become as legendary as you. Even among your fellow knights, you stand out. You did not choose to be named the Bloody Red Baron. Your name, reputation, and red triplane have become symbols of a superb and fearless challenger. You know this image has helped you. The sight of your bright red triplane strikes fear into the heart of your enemy. This can help win a battle before the first shot is ever fired. In an instant, everyone knows who you are. You are the highest scoring ace in this great war with 80 victories. Only 25 years old, you are a leader and a legend. But you also know your reputation and the fabric of your aircraft will not shield you from the intent and the bullets of your challengers. A squadron of enemy aircraft appears on the horizon. Just as you intended, they recognize you instantly and realize they are in for the fight of their lives. You dive in pursuit of your 81st victory. Little do you know, this fight will end up at treetop level. Little do you know, this fight will end up over enemy machine gun nests. And little do you know, this fight will be your last. As in life, Baron von Richthofen was respected in death, not only by his countrymen, but by his enemy as well. For they buried him with full military honors and a 21-gun salute. As in life, where he became a legend and fell, in death, his legend rose to new heights. Whether known by his enemy as the Red Baron, or by his fellow countrymen as Der Rote Kampfflieger, his name and the plane he flew went down in history as the most famous and recognized of all aerial fighter combinations. We remember uniqueness because it stands out from the crowd, and standing out from the crowd can be used to help us achieve our mission and goals. Look at famous figures throughout history and how standing out from the crowd helped promote their causes and careers. But standing out from the crowd can be a double-edged sword, for it always creates controversy. Some will want to see you succeed, as it assures them that they have the potential to succeed as well. But others may be jealous of your success and want to see you fail. They may not agree with your purpose or be willing to admit that they are less accomplished. What happens when we stand out from the crowd? What are the rewards? What are the costs? Should we just go for it? Or is there a balance? Not everyone that stands out from the crowd ends up in tragedy. How might you stand out from the crowd? And how might standing out help you accomplish your mission, your dreams, and your goals?